Matthews in 740. That was a fine piece of surgery.
Oh, thanks very much. I appreciate it. Keep your chin up, okay?
Wait a minute, Andy.
Hmm?
Would you like a word with you in private?
Yeah?
If you're not too busy.
No. Okay.
I understand you're scheduled to receive your scrub nurse diploma today.
Yes, we completed our course.
And you passed with flying colors. However, the diploma you received today will not be signed or filled in. At the present time, you'll be on probation for at least a month. And you have to earn this diploma ethically as well as professionally. Now, I think this is a fair arrangement, and I hope you agree.
Yeah, I guess I don't have much choice, do I?
No, you don't. We all have to pay for our mistakes in this world, Anne. And when this is over, your diploma will mean that much more to you.
Best classes ever. And I want to wish you all success in your new endeavor. Remember that a surgeon is totally reliant on his scrub nurse. And now it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Steve Hardy, who will hand out your diplomas. Dr. Hardy?
Thank you. But I think we should save the applause for the operation theater. Before I hand out these long-awaited diplomas, there's a few words I'd like to say. This is an awesome responsibility you're taking on, as I'm sure you all know. Scrub nurses require courage, nerves of steel, strong instincts. As individuals, you'll be asked to endure long hours on your feet under difficult working conditions and with short-tempered doctors. There is no coffee break in the operating room, only immediacy and tension. Without question, it's a very difficult job, but it's also a very rewarding one because no other phase of medicine offers quite the same drama and challenge as surgery. Good luck to all of you. You have my appreciation and my good luck to you. But if you do decide to have a good, long party tonight, I hope you'll invite me. Mrs. Barrows? Schlenker. Miss Joffe. Miss Wong. Miss Logan.
Good to see your smiling face.
Is it safe?
Well, yeah, of course it's safe.
No sinister little men with guns?
Not today.
Oh, that's a relief.
Yeah, I'm sorry about the last visit.
Oh, that's all right. As a matter of fact, I found it very stimulating.
Well, the only goon you'll find in the boat today is me. Now, what's up?
Well, we need your help.
Your continuing help in a matter of extreme urgency.
I love it. Go on.
Well, are you sure no one's listening?
Aside from the three of us, there's not a soul on the boat.
Here we go.
Thank you. And Luke, where is he?
Well, he's over at his Aunt Ruby's today. We can all talk freely.
Well, Robert, as you probably guessed, this has to do with a woman that I asked you to locate some time ago.
The deceased one?
Mm-hmm. I think you mentioned at the time that she had a son.
Hmm. Her only survivor, name's Eric.
Well, it's essential that I find that boy.
Well, that shouldn't be too difficult. I mean, I've already got quite a few leads. What do I do when I find him?
Well, report to me where he is.
That's it?
Yes. However, it's very important that the boy does not know that I'm looking for him. And, of course, not a word to Edward about this.
Certainly. I assume you want a dossier on him?
Absolutely.
All right, well, I'll make a few calls and get started immediately.
Thank you, Mr. Scorpio.
Thank you. And be careful.
Thank you. Good luck, Robin.
Bye, Lila.
Bye, Lila.
Miriam, Robert Scorpio. Listen, remember that little job I spoke to you about last month? That's the one. Luke? Luke? Robert?
That's careless. Rose knows that I'm here. Well, that's beautiful, boys. That's beautiful. Luke, anybody here?
Bad, we're getting there.
Well,
later, boys.
I must say I'm very impressed.
The earring symbol of Laura. The model symbol of Titan. The sterling rose symbol of Cassadine. With these items, their destiny we now control. So be it.
I think we're on the same side.
Who the hell are you?
I was just about to ask you the same thing.
I'm staying on board, a friend of Scorpio's.
Friend of Scorpio's, huh? Maybe I ought to go up and ask him.
That won't be necessary.
Maybe I think it is necessary.
You'll be making the biggest and last mistake of your life.
You work for Helena Cassadine, don't you?
That's none of your business.
Well, I think it is my business. You know why? Because I think you and I are on the same side.
Yeah? What makes you think that?
Well, I caught some of that mumbo-jumbo stuff.
Oh, and that puts us on the same side, huh?
Well, let's just put it this way. I think we both have the same plans for Luke and Laura.
Then you won't interrupt my mission? I still have half of it to accomplish.
Half of it?
Yeah, it's a complicated procedure.
Complicated, huh?
Look, I'm waiting for your answer. Will you or won't you interfere?
No, I won't. I think plans are much more creative than mine. In fact, if you need any help, I'm staying at the Croydon Hotel.
Mm-hmm.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, likewise.
About the mess, maid's day off.
Oh, I don't mind it. As a matter of fact, I kind of like it. It's like a dream that's half come true.
All right, well, let's have the other half then. How about some wine?
Twist my arm.
You got it.
You know, Rose, there's something I didn't say before.
What's that?
You look absolutely fantastic.
Thanks.
I meant it.
I'm sorry, it's just the... Thank you. It's been a long time since anybody said that to me. Like Joe was just saying today, I don't get out nearly enough.
Joe's right.
Well,
I better get rid of this. Set up a bit of mood here. And damn it!
What?
The sawdust all over this freshly painted shellac.
Well, how do you think that happened?
I don't know. I guess the wind blew it in. I'm going to have to totally redo it.
Why not just let Luke do it?
That's a great idea. I'll put it in the suggestion box. Now, what we need is some music. Then... and one more touch.
Whose idea was this?
Yours.
Mine, me too. Pat myself on the back. Now I can't get over how beautiful you are tonight.
You're really going to have to stop. I'm getting embarrassed.
Oh, I'm sorry. Lost control just for a second, though. Right. Now, tonight, Rose Kelly, I drink to you. Your warmth. Your generosity. In a world that's too often uncaring.
And to the haunted star.
I'll always drink to that.
Why the haunted star?
You mean why did we specifically name it the haunted star?
Yeah, you know, you have to admit it's an odd name for a nightclub.
Okay, well, the star refers to Miss Star Eyes Spencer. The haunted? Well, that's up for grabs.
But there's a chance that the boat is haunted.
It depends on who you listen to.
Such a gentleman. Thank you so much. This looks lovely.
You'd like some more wine?
No, I'm fine, thank you.
We have plenty left.
No, that's fine. Contrary to popular rumor, no, I am not an alcoholic, you know.
Annie, you know that's not what I meant.
I know that's not what you meant. I'm sorry, I am overly sensitive. I apologize.
Well, with good reason. People have been a little harsh.
You could say that. Mm. Have you heard about my probation?
Yeah, I did, actually. I thought that was rather stiff punishment.
Yeah, they know where to hit where it hurts. I suppose the hard part comes now when I have to prove I'm a good scrub nurse, though.
Ah. I know you're a good scrub nurse, and you'll be surprised how fast the month goes and how many people forget in that month.
Yeah. Well, I'm never going to forget. I was wrong to accuse anybody of anything without proper proof, that's for sure.
Proper proof, and proof of the proof, and proof of the proof of the proof. And cheers. You look very pretty when you smile. You should do that more often.
Thank you. I would if I had more to smile about.
Oh, are things that bad?
Oh, it's just the changes I've been going through. I don't know, Noah. You know, I have lost just about every man I've ever known because of this moral stance I've taken in my life. And here I've gone and have changed my image, so to speak. And I think everybody hates it.
No, I think you're wrong.
Oh, I've seen the faces. I've seen the looks. Nobody approves.
You think nobody approves?
Mm-mm.
I think you find you're wrong, Annie. You know, it seems like you're just stuck in the middle at the moment. Now, these strong beliefs aren't something you can just throw away overnight. It takes time.
And patience, which I'm very, very short of.
Listen, do me a favor. Don't throw them away altogether. I think you'll find that beliefs like you have are... they give you a lot of strength at certain times.
You know something?
What?
I think that's pretty good advice.
And take it.
Let's toast.
Hey, you know what? No matter who you are, you'll always have a friend in me. That's for life.
Robert, this is a sight of you I've never seen before.
Then you must bring it out of me, my dear, because I can't remember when I've had so much fun.
I better get dessert.
Why didn't I think of that?
I'll get it.
Hey, shouldn't leave things like that lying around.
Yeah, somebody could get hurt.
Is that what bothers you?
I think I'll go ahead and cut the pie.
Show me that.
Well, that pie spoil if it's left to sit there.
No.
Then let's dance.